The story of the prodigal son is a wonderful example of the glory of the gospel of Christ and of the amazing grace of God. The word prodigal can be defined as recklessly wasteful, extravagant, profuse in giving, or exceedingly abundant. The younger son in this story was indeed prodigal. He was willing to consider his father as dead so that he might receive an inheritance. After he received his father's money, he left home and squandered all that he had with loose living. As a result of his recklessness, he found himself living with the pigs. It didn't take long for him to come to his senses. His reckless extravagance brought him to poverty and bondage. He had lived his life according to his passions and discovered that his passions had left him bankrupt. He decided it was better to go home and face his father. One could understand that the father might be very angry. But as the son was extravagant in his sinful rebellion, so the father was extravagant in his love and mercy. The father never gave up on his son. Even though the son treated the father as dead, the father never forgot his son. As his young son approached home, the father saw him and felt compassion for him, ran and embraced him and kissed him. Although the son was willing to return as a servant in his father's house, the father was willing only to have a son. This is truly a prodigal love. The older son did not understand the extravagant grace of the father. Those of us who have never really been in trouble all too often have difficulty extending grace to our foolish brothers and sisters who always seem to be in trouble, but the Father does not. Jesus once said that each time a sinner repents, the angels in heaven rejoice. We may often find ourselves in trouble because of our rebellious ways, but we will never find ourselves removed from the extravagance of God's grace. And when we return to God, we will always find him ready to celebrate our homecoming. This has been Dan Tomblin.